Hello and welcome to video lecture series in political science. Today we are going to discuss chapter 5 titled as Contemporary South Asia from your class 12th textbook Contemporary World Politics. As you know that for understanding we have divided this chapter into 6 parts, and in all these 6 parts we are going to talk about various countries in South Asia and their relationship with India and with each other. Now so far in the first 2 parts of this chapter we have discussed about SAARC, formation of SAARC. What are the objectives of SAARC, what are the principles that SAARC countries follow and how they cooperate with each other. We also raised a question that why SAARC has been not very successful. We are attempting to understand history of South Asian nations and identify the reason behind the mutual suspicion and mistrust between these countries. In the journey, we have so far discussed the relationship between India and Bhutan and India and Nepal. Today we will discuss about the relationship between India and Bangladesh. Now Bangladesh, which is officially also known as People's Republic of Bangladesh, is located in South Asia. It is world's 8th most populous country. The east, west and north of Bangladesh, as you can see in the map, is surrounded by India and the south touches Bay of Bengal. Bangladesh, like Bhutan and Nepal, is landlocked, surrounded on 3 sides by India. Today, we will discuss about the process and struggle of establishing democracy in Bangladesh. What has been the nature of relationship between India and Bangladesh, and what are the areas where the two countries have conflict with each other and the areas where they cooperate with each other. Now, as you can see in this map, Bangladesh is shown yellow in color, which is surrounded by India from all the 3 sides. A small part of it touches Myanmar and on the south it touches Bay of Bengal. Now Bangladesh is a very interesting case because Bangladesh came into existence very late in 1971. Let us discuss the struggle for establishment of democracy in Bangladesh and the process of establishment of Bangladesh itself. How Bangladesh came into being or in existence. Now what happened, we have to go back a bit in history to understand this. After partition of India and Pakistan in 1947, Bangladesh was part of Pakistan. It was known as East Pakistan. As you can see it in the map, the 2 territories shown green in color on east and west side of Pakistan are East Pakistan and West Pakistan. East Pakistan, which would later become Bangladesh, and the West Pakistan, which is the main Pakistan land only. East Pakistan consisted of areas of Assam and Bengal. Although population in both the regions, East and West Pakistan, was almost equal, but the political power was concentrated in the hands of the political groups in West Pakistan. It was widely perceived that East Pakistan was facing or was being exploited economically by the people in West Pakistan. People in this region were also unhappy because of imposition of Urdu as main language. The language controversy ultimately reached a point where East Bengal revolted against the imposition of Urdu as the only language in Pakistan, which includes both East and West. People started protesting against the marginalized treatment given to the Bengali culture, language and people. Several students and civilians lost their life in the protest when police held a crackdown on 21st of Feb in 1952. These people demanded for a fair representation of East Pakistanis in administration and equal share in the power. During this time, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman of Awami League Party emerged popular for his opposition to the ethnic and institutional discrimination of Bengalis, who comprised the majority of the Pakistanis population. Mujibur Rahman demanded for the autonomy of the province, and he also strongly opposed the military rule of Field Marshal Ayub Khan. As you can see Sheikh Mujibur Rahman in the picture, he was the first president of Bangladesh from 1971 to 1972 only. However, he led the major protest against, headed by Awami League against the West Pakistanis. And this in the picture you see Agha Yahya Khan, who was the third president of Pakistan from 1969 to 1971. Now, what happened in the general elections which were held in the month of December in 1970s? The Awami League under the leadership of Mujibur Rahman won a massive majority in the provincial legislature, forming a clear-cut majority. Out of a total of 291 seats, the Awami League won 151 seats in the East Pakistan. In the West Pakistan, on the other hand, the largest and most successful party was the Pakistan People's Party, headed by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. This party won 81 seats. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was the 9th Prime Minister of Pakistan from 1973 to 1977. The government dominated by leaders from West Pakistan refused to convene the National Assembly after the results of the election were declared. Mujibur Rahman called for independence and he asked people to launch a major campaign of civil disobedience and organized armed resistance against the domination of the West Pakistanis. Mujibur Rahman was arrested and he was moved to West Pakistan and was kept under heavy guard in a jail near Faisalabad. The Pakistani army was ordered by the president to suppress the mass revolt happening in East Pakistan. The army was sent to East Pakistan, but soon the operation for securing peace and order turned into a rampage of terror and bloodshed, and thousands of people were killed by Pakistani army. Fearing their lives, a large number of Bangladeshis started migrating to India as refugees. This created a problem of refugees in India. India supported the demand of Awami League for independence, and it also provided military and financial help to the people to fight their war for independence. Indira Gandhi was at this point of time Prime Minister of India. Political leadership from India persuaded Pakistan to stop this rampage, to curtail the problem of refugees in India. But when, despite repeated talks to stop violence in Bangladesh, Pakistan did not listen to or relent, India had to take a military action against Pakistan. This resulted in a war between India and Pakistan on both Eastern and West Front. The war ended in the surrender of Pakistani forces in East Pakistan and independence of East Pakistan, which was later on called as Bangladesh. After the release of Mujibur Rahman, he assumed the provincial presidency for a while. Later, Mujibur Rahman took over office as the Prime Minister of Independent Bangladesh. The new constitution of Bangladesh adopted four fundamental principles of nationalism, secularism, democracy, and socialism. But surprisingly, within few years, in 1975, Mujibur Rahman got constitution amended from parliamentary to presidential form of government, and he banned all other parties except his own party, the Awami League. And he assumed extraordinary powers and suppressed any kind of opposition of his ideas. In a series of tragic political developments, on August 15, 1975, a group of army officers invaded the presidential residence and they assassinated Mujibur Rahman, his family and personal staff. The army chief Ziaur Rahman, after the coup in 1977, took control of Bangladesh. Ziaur Rahman also formed his own Bangladesh National Party and he won elections in 1979. Ziaur Rahman was also assassinated later and Lieutenant General H.M. Irshad took over in 1982. Now, soon after these series of political takeovers, there were protests all over in support for demand for democracy. These protests were mainly headed by students from universities. Irshad was forced to allow political activity to some extent. He was later elected as president of Bangladesh and he remained in power till 1990, when a mass demonstration forced him to step down from the position of power. Parliamentary elections were held in 1991, and since then, multi-party representative democracy has been functioning in Bangladesh, and to a certain extent it has been successful. Now let us look at the relationship between India and Bangladesh. India has social, cultural and economic relationships with Bangladesh. This relationship is multidimensional. Bangladesh has been one of the countries of focus in India's Look East policy, which is one of the component of India's foreign policy. India and Bangladesh have cooperated with each other on environmental issues and disaster management. India is also one of the important trading partners for Bangladesh. The two-way trade in the year 2011 and 12 was $5.242 billion. India's exports to Bangladesh accounted for $4.73 billion and imports were a bit less, accounting only $0.498. India also offers economic assistance to Bangladesh for development. India has extended a line of credit of $1 billion to Bangladesh for a range of projects, including construction of railway infrastructure, supply of locomotives and passenger coaches, procurement of buses and dredging projects also. In order to promote people-to-people exchanges between the two countries, the Indian government also offers a large number of scholarships to students from Bangladesh. The scholarships are offered for higher education and pursuing general courses in arts, science, engineering. They are also offering scholarships to pursue specialized courses in culture, drama, music, fine arts, sports, etc. You will be surprised to know that 3 diplomats from Bangladesh were imparted training at Foreign Services Institute in New Delhi in the year 2011. Now, given the shared history and commonality of language, that is Bengali culture, these cultural exchanges form an important bond of friendship between people of two countries. Special emphasis has been laid on promotion of exchanges in the fields of music, theatre, art, painting, literature, etc. between the two countries. But there have also been some issues creating differences between India and Bangladesh. One such issue is sharing of water of river Ganga and Brahmaputra. Indian government is also unhappy with Bangladesh for supporting anti-Indian Islamic fundamentalist groups. They are unhappy for not having taken any action against them. You know that India faces a security threat from large number of illegal migrants coming from Bangladesh, and some terrorists also get a passage during the process of illegal migration. Bangladesh also did not allow Indian troops to move to the northern eastern states of India through its territory. Bangladesh decided not to export natural gas to India, and neither did it allow Myanmar to do so through its territory. On the other hand, government in Bangladesh feels that India is a dominant power in the South Asian region and it takes undue advantage of its dominance in the matters such as sharing of river water, in which India tries to stop the supply of river water. India is also encouraging, they think that India is also encouraging rebels in Chittagong Hills. They also feel that India is unfair in its trade and is trying to extract natural gas from Bangladesh. So there are some areas of cooperation and there are some areas of mistrust that create differences and friction between the two countries. Various issues need to be resolved if the relationship between India and Bangladesh are to be improved. These issues are about sharing of many international rivers that flow from India to Bangladesh. Issues of border patrolling, that is, the police keeps a check on illegal migration from Bangladesh to India. And also an issue of mutual cooperation to stop cross-border terrorism. On the positive side about cooperation, that is helping each other in development of infrastructure, can boost economic development and growth in both the regions. In the future, both Bangladesh and India are looking to broaden their area of cooperation by identifying areas of common interest, concern to both and taking care of needs of each other. Bangladesh not only shares the longest international border with India, which is approximately 3,500 kilometers, and is also not only the largest trading partner of India within the SAARC region, but Bangladesh is also strategically located vis-a-vis India's connectivity to Southeast Asia. So that is why Bangladesh happens to be one of the important countries with which India needs to have good relation, and Bangladesh also needs to have good relation with India. To conclude, let's summarize what we discussed in this part of the chapter. In this part, we started our discussion with understanding separation of East Pakistan from West Pakistan, which were the two areas or the regions that were formed or established after partition of India and Pakistan. We discussed about the conflict between the two, East and West Pakistan, and independence of Bangladesh, in which India also helped Bangladesh to achieve independence. We discussed about the successive governments in Bangladesh, the authoritarian regimes, and the establishment of democracy since 1991. We discussed about the relationship between India and Bangladesh, various areas where the two countries have cooperated with each other, and what are the minor issues over which the two nations have conflict. In the next part of this chapter, we will discuss in detail the relationship between India and Sri Lanka. Till then, enjoy reading this part of the chapter. Thank you.